His name is funny. Is this a competition? Yours is not far off. Not funny, too much sarcasm, very opinionated, and what are you doing here, man? This is YouTube, you should be in CNN. Jaime, that was one of the slowest outros you've ever made. I caught every word, and man, I'm gonna have to delete that video and start it all over again. That's right, it's that time of the week. I am Jaime Rivera, this is Pocket Now, and this is our Pocket Now Daily Recap for last week. So last Monday, I asked you, what would you price the Nexus 5 after all the leak specification info? We've got a ton of leaks, almost everything we need to know about this phone, and we have 966 comments, out of which, for example, Aaron says, honestly, if they would allow for expandable memory and keep it at the same price range, neither Apple nor Samsung could match it. And yes, you have a very solid point, but keep in mind, subsidies, for example, one of the biggest advantages that companies have that Google does not want to have is subsidies. And given the price of the Nexus 5, that makes sense, but still, the subsidies are really what lures a lot of people into getting other phones. Stanley says, I'd price it at $299 for the base model and they would just kill competition. And yes, $299 would be just an insane price tag. We've got some leaks of $349, which really make more sense for me particularly. I think that that's like the price that they're going to go for, at least for the base model. We've got a lot of leaks that back that up. Still, $299 would be just amazing. And the official Prax says $299 for the 16 gig model, no contract, $349 for the 32 gig model, no contract, and yes, 46 thumbs up because that would be like the dream price tag. Though I would wish that for those $50 of the extra price, they would just give us more options. And you know what? If they would give me a $50 option to get expandable storage like the first comment, this would be the perfect phone. Then on Tuesday, I asked you if you would buy the Galaxy Round. We had some leaks of this phone that day, and then the next day it got released, and it's probably one of the funniest things I've ever seen, so much so that we have 1,152 comments, out of which Chris says, ridiculous. It looks okay, but what's so amazing about it? A gimmick from Samsung, and yes, for me, this is like the first hardware gimmick that I've ever really seen. I don't find the point in a rounded display, and especially when it's rounded from side to side. A lot of people say that it's for one-handed usability, but this phone is just so big that you still have to require monster hands like mine for that to even make sense. Then Carl says, I'd prefer 3D over this round crap, and no, I'm not gonna agree with you. 3D smartphone displays already existed, and they were terrible. They were just so bad that nobody even bought them, cared, and the phones were just so thick that it just did not make sense, so I'm sadly not gonna agree with you. Then Vitaly says, poor rich Samsung, and you know what? Samsung is one of those companies that's actually setting the bar for R&D. They're not just spending money on it, they're also publishing what they've got, and you know, they're doing it because they can, but I'm not gonna debate it because the Galaxy Note lineup was born out of something like this and it worked. People like it. So if they have the money to spend and they're willing to throw it out there, then why not? I love the fact that they experiment, though some of these things just don't make sense. Then on Wednesday, I asked you if you would buy a device that dual boots Android and Windows Phone because the news were about Microsoft actually pushing certain OEMs to do it, you know, not necessarily on their own tier, but actually Microsoft incentivizing for this to happen. And so we have 691 comments, out of which dual OS, I wonder if a 16 gigabyte Galaxy S4 would have any space left. And yeah, that would definitely be a problem with TouchWiz, but remember that this is the other way around. There's actually Windows products that want to run Android. And if that were stock Android, that would be amazing. Then another commenter says, dual boot is useless for Android users. It's just a way for Microsoft to have more users. And you know, it's funny that we're actually talking about this now because so many years ago, this would have been unheard of. Microsoft was so big. It was the dominating company, the dominating force of technology. And now they're actually looking for ways to get other operating systems to work on theirs, which is just odd. And for those of you that wonder if you could do it in Apple products, yes, Bootcamp has existed for the longest time, and that's one way that Apple try to get Mac users. So yeah, Microsoft is doing the same. I'm not going to blame them. Then Francisco says dual boot equals Nokia salvation. And we've dreamed about this. Imagine a Lumia 1020 running Android. I don't have anything against Windows Phone. The problem is really the fact that the things that I use on it are not available. We use a lot of Google services here at Pocket Now, so it's pretty much useless for me and most of the team. But still, if we had the option to run Android on that thing, it would be just the perfect phone in my personal opinion. Then on Thursday, I asked you if you like what HTC was planning with the fingerprint scanner of the HTC One Max, because back then the phone was not released yet. And the rumors were that you could launch specific applications with different fingers, which you can actually do in a very terrible way. So we have 378 comments, out of which, yeah, it's just a bloated HTC One and it's stupid. And, you know, sadly, that's our opinion as well. There is really no point in such a big phone. And I'm talking a phone that's much bigger than the Galaxy Note 3. There is just no point in a bigger phone if you really can't do more with that bigger display, except for gaming, which is actually not necessarily bad, again, but it's just a bigger HTC One that you don't really have to put up with. Then another commenter says, how am I supposed to hold the phone with my thumb on its back? And, you know, probably one of the things that Michael Fisher said in his review that made a lot of sense was that that fingerprint scanner at the back was really uncomfortable if you have your phone on the table. And the fingerprint scanning technology was terrible. It almost never worked, so it was kind of pointless. And Momodo25 says, if it works, HTC will kill the 5S, and sadly, no, it did not work. And finally, on Friday, I asked you if you would buy an iPhone 5C if the price would drop, because back then the rumors were, or pretty much the confirmation, that Apple is actually churning a lot of phones. They're not meeting their goals, and they have a lot of iPhone 5Cs in stock, up to the point where they're not really ordering more 5Cs from manufacturers and just sticking with the stock that they have for the holiday season. And we've got 1,130 comments, out of which one of them says, why buy iPhone when you can have a much more advanced device for the same price? And yeah, in the case of something like the Nexus 4 or the future Nexus 5, the iPhone 5C is just not going to make sense. Then Muhammad says, I would buy the iPhone 5C if it were 50% cheaper. And if you're talking about a contract price, yes, if it were free on contract, it would make sense. But don't forget about that price for an unlocked phone. That's just not going to happen. And then Alexandra says, the problem is not the price, but the fact that this is the same phone over and over again. And you make a very solid point. And I'm actually going to talk about that in both ways. Number one, it is so close to the iPhone 5S that for an extra $100, I'd rather buy the higher end model. And then on the other side, I mean, think about it. You can get an iPhone 5 on eBay for a much cheaper price than the iPhone 5C and keep the 5S design. So it really does not make sense for you to buy the iPhone 5C overall. Even if they dropped the price, they would still have to make a compelling case, meaning subsidies or whatever, for that phone to make sense. So great comment there. That's it for our Pocket Now Daily Recap. Thank you very much for watching. A couple of tips if you want your comments to be featured. Number one, keep them short. Number two, stick to the point. And number three, try to get some thumbs up. It makes them easier to spot. You can also follow us on social media and subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. Please follow me on Twitter, @Jaime_Rivera. Give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I am Jaime Rivera. Thank you very much for watching. We've got a lot of coverage coming up next week.